Excuse me, Mr. Marston. Have you seen my father anywhere?
No.
He went out this morning to ride the land and was supposed to be back hours ago. I don't know. The ranch hands have been out looking, but so far they've found nothing.
Well, come on. Let's go look for him.
Thank you, Mr. Marston. I'm sure it's nothing, but I worry about the old fool. Feeling about this. It's not like him to be away for so long.
Don't worry. We'll find him.
He's not as young as he used to be. What if he's hurt himself?
Your father can still handle himself just fine, Miss McFarland. He's built like an oak.
You're probably right, but I can't help worrying. He's all I've got. Yeah!
Don't you have any brothers or sisters, Miss McFarland?
I had six brothers, but five of them died. Either from sickness or foolish choices.
And the other one?
He left for the East and never came back. Must be getting on for 10 years ago now. He's a high and mighty banker in New York, according to his last letter.
He should be here, helping you and your pa.
I don't want his help. He can live his life any way he wants. But when I see those city fellers coming in on the railway, all dressed up like a sore toe, I fear a little for his soul. He switched his saddle for a tie, and that's fine. I just never met a man in a tie I could trust. Who's that over there?
Yeah.
Come on, boy. Quick as you can. Stay with me. Daddy, what happened?
Nothing nice. Wrestlers, I guess. Maybe the Baller twins, that bunch. Now, you head back to the ranch right now and fetch the wagon.
Yes, sir.
Marston, you watch after her.
I'll do that, sir.
It's a bad idea to split up right now.
Come on!
What could have happened to those poor men? And their horses are dead, too. Stay with me. I've got a bad feeling about this.
I think we should get back there as soon as we can.
Who could have done something like that?
Your pa seemed to have an idea who it was. Let's just do what he says and get the wagon.
Those damn rustlers! I've got a good mind to head over to Pike's Basin myself.
I don't think that's a good idea.
And you're no better. How many men have you killed?
Do you really want to know?
It's disgusting.
You never met the men I killed.
I heard the way you talk about that gang you were in. Like there was some twisted morality to what you did.
We all have...
Look, Mr. Marston, the barn is on fire! Gee up!
Yeah.
We're trapped in there. We gotta get to the horse.
It's getting worse.
There's no way in through the front.
Put it off.
Try and get in through the loft, Mr. Marston.
Get a move!
Climb up the windmill!
Come on!
This ain't working!
Más agua! Los caballos!
Thank you.
Let's go!
Sure know how to handle yourself. Thanks, Marston.
Yes, John, thanks. You, well, you saved the ranch.
If you'll excuse me, I've got chores to attend to. Hey, hold on a second over there.
Sincerely, John, thank you.
Well, I did all I could, Miss McFarlane. Sorry about all the damage. That gang seems to really want you out of here.
Yeah, well, my father fought Indians. I scarcely think we're gonna be frightened by some white trash.
White trash can be pretty frightening.
Well, they don't frighten me.
Good.
John, my family owes you a great debt.
I think you got enough debt. You saved my life. All I ask of you is this. If I get back home and get my farm started back up, you'll sell me some cattle. I prefer doing business with people I know.
Of course, Mr. Marston. It'd be my pleasure. Well, you get some rest. I've got to go see how my father's bearing up.